that you caused my machine not to work. Mm-hmm. And Lord, I say thank you for that. Thank you, Lord. Thank you also because I was not bringing my iPad on this trip. And the last minute I thought, no, let me pack it in there. Thank you for that, Father. Thank you for the messages that you have given me each time to share with my sisters. Usually you know me, I'm prepared, organized, I'm an A-time personality. But this time you took me on a faith walk. Yes. I have to admit, Lord, I didn't like it too much, but I have to praise you for it. Yes. But I'm also asking, don't do it too often. But Father, I pray for my sisters today, yes. Each one of them. You know their lives. You know all that has happened in their past to make them who they are right now. You know the traumas they have suffered or are suffering. You know the abuse that has gone on or is going on in their lives. You know the children that are giving them such a difficult time. You know maybe their relationship with their spouse isn't going the way it's supposed to go, and he doesn't want help where she may want help. You know that there are women here who are single and who feel lonely and abandoned and forgotten. Lord, help them to know that one is not a lonely number, because they have you with them all the time. Help us, Lord, to be able to say, like Paul, I am content. Mm-hmm. Whatever place I may be, I'm content. Because as we are content with what we are, where we are, who we are, that's when you can begin to do things in our lives. Help us to stop fussing and fuming and complaining and criticizing and just that. Put all that stuff aside. Because until we put that aside, and it's okay to fuss and complain, but it's not okay to keep doing it every day, every day, every day. It's okay for us to be angry with you, but then we've got to move on. It's okay for us to be discouraged, but then we've got to move on. We're human beings, negative emotions come naturally to us. But because we know Jesus, we've got to move beyond the negative to the positive. And I want to pray for any of my sisters here today who may be suffering with depression or anxiety or with an unforgiving heart or who may be dealing with anger issues because of trauma in their life. Lord, I pray for your healing and help for them. I pray that they will seek the help they need. Just like we go to a doctor for diabetes, we go to a doctor when we have anxiety attacks or depression problems or anger issues. We go to a psychologist, whatever it is we need to do, Lord, let us do it. Because you have given us the ability to, and you've given us people who have the ability to help us. So let us get that help and not just sit and say, no, I'm not going to do anything. I don't like taking tablets. I don't like doing this. Father, you have such patience with us. I don't know how you do it, Lord. Because we're a miserable bunch of people. We think Israel were bad. Israel, the people of Israel are cakewalk compared to us. We complain over everything, we fuss over everything, we want more of everything, we are jealous of other people who have, we feel that we must show everything that we've got when we go out, we feel we must dress a certain way and behave a certain way, and Lord, help us to get rid of all that stuff. We need Jesus. We want salvation. Most of all, we want heaven. So help us to live each day with a heaven-centered view. Help us to stop looking down. Because when we look down, all we see is the filth and the problems. Help us to keep looking up to Jesus. Thank you so much, Lord, for loving us and for caring for us and for every word you have spoken to our hearts. Help us not to keep these words to ourselves, but to go and share it with someone else, that it might encourage also. So now, Lord, we give you thanks, we give you honor, we give you glory. And we end by singing this little song. Turn your